Let me ask you something. How secure do you think Bitcoin transactions really are? Well, imagine a lock so secure no computer on Earth could crack it in a million years. That's the power behind every Bitcoin transaction you make, and it's all thanks to something called SHA-256. SHA-256 is, let's say, Bitcoin's digital fingerprint maker. Every piece of data that enters the Bitcoin network gets processed through mathematics. It can take anything you put in, let's say an entire book, and transforms it into a unique 64-character code. Without it, there would be nothing of what makes Bitcoin what it is today. No trust, no security, no way to verify that your Bitcoin is actually yours. Put simply, it's what allows everyone around the world to transact without needing banks or governments to vouch for them. I know this might sound a bit complicated, but bear with me. As in this video, we are going to learn what SHA-256 is, how it works, and why it's important to Bitcoin success. All I'm asking from you is to watch the whole video, and if you really, really care about Bitcoin, to share it with your internet friends. Alright, so, as we all know, before Bitcoin, digital transactions required banks to verify and approve every payment. Someone had to act as the middleman, keeping track of who owned what. But Bitcoin completely changed this. Instead of relying on institutions, it uses mathematics, specifically the SHA-256 hash function, to create trust. A hash function is nothing more than just a cool mathematical process that transforms any data into a unique fixed-length code, or in other words, as you will hear me say, a digital fingerprint. Think of it as the wax seal on an ancient letter. Just as a broken seal would reveal tampering, any change to Bitcoin data, even a single character, produces a completely different hash. This is what makes fraud virtually impossible. If someone tries to change a transaction amount, let's say from $10 to $1,000, the hash would completely change, immediately notifying the network to the tampering attempt. But SHA-256 does more than just detect fraud. It's the key of Bitcoin mining. Mining is simply the mechanism that adds new transactions to the blockchain and releases new bitcoins into circulation. That's how new bitcoins are created, basically. And miners are computers that compete to solve complex mathematical puzzles based on SHA-256 computations. The first miner to solve the puzzle gets to add the next block to the Bitcoin chain and earn the block reward. As you can imagine, this creates a strong cycle of security. Miners compete to solve SHA-256 puzzles, earning rewards, which attracts more miners, making the network even harder to attack. The more miners participate, the more secure Bitcoin becomes, and SHA-256 is right at the center of it. Now, let's have a look at SHA-256's essential parts. First, there's the input, which can be literally anything. A transaction record, a block of data, even this entire video script. SHA-256 doesn't care what you feed it, the function treats everything the same way. Next comes the transformation process. Think of SHA-256 as a blender. You add in your data, and it scrambles everything into, let's say, a nice smoothie. The output is where things get interesting. No matter what you put in, SHA-256 always spits out exactly 64 characters. These aren't random letters and numbers, they're hexadecimal characters, meaning they only use digits 0 to 9 and letters A to F. A typical Bitcoin transaction hash might look like this, for example. But it gets even more interesting. SHA-256 has three critical properties that make it perfect for Bitcoin. First, it's deterministic. What that means is that if you feed SHA-256 the exact same transaction details, like sender, receiver, and timestamp, you will always get the same hash. Second, it's one way. You can't work backwards from the hash to discover the original data. And third, it's avalanche sensitive, meaning that if you change even one tiny bit of input, the entire output changes completely. So how does Bitcoin actually use SHA-256 in practice? Easy. First, SHA-256 secures transactions. That basically means that every time you send Bitcoin, the network creates a hash of your transaction details. This hash becomes part of the permanent record, making it impossible for anyone to change the transaction later. Second, SHA-256 creates the blockchain structure itself. Each block in the Bitcoin blockchain contains a hash of the previous block, creating a chain. It's similar to a DNA strand. Each block inherits genetic information from its parent, and any attempt to change the past would break the entire chain. This is why Bitcoin's history is considered immutable. Finally, there is something called nonce. Basically, this is just a random number that miners guess repeatedly by running everything through SHA-256 until they find one that produces a hash meeting specific criteria. The Bitcoin network requires hashes to start with a certain number of zeros, which is a very difficult task for miners and requires enormous computational power. And by the way, this is the exact same nonce that Satoshi's computer used to generate the first ever block, also known as the Genesis block. And here is the first block hash in Bitcoin history. Understanding Bitcoin isn't easy, but seeing beyond the nice orange color will help you understand why Bitcoin is more important than ever. Today we learned about SHA-256 and why it's important. So let me know in the comments below what you guys would like to see next. And as always, thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video.